ourselves or our family or friends, to society as a whole. There is something deeper that needs to be looked at for all of us. Today is Valentine's Day, and it's also Ash Wednesday. And I think it's just beautiful how these two, the secular holiday and the religious observance of the start of Lent, intersected on this year. So Lent is about not looking on inward beauty and being impressed with the things of the world, but instead upon looking on the human heart and what cannot be repaired by medicine or a doctor or a therapist of any kind, but what can be repaired only by our good relationship with God and with each other. In the scriptures that we read, Linda did a super job of reading those. There's two scriptures I'm going to refer to. So the first one is from Joel. It's on page 3 of your bulletin. And so to me, this is a real thematic two verses about what we are called to do as God's people. Constantly, but especially in the 6 weeks of Lent. Verse 12 and 13. Yet even now, says the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting and weeping and mourning. Rend your hearts and not your clothing. Return to the Lord your God, for God is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love. And God relents from punishing. Those are two super, super key verses of Lent, that we are to return to God, and that we're to give up to God whatever is breaking our hearts, whatever is breaking the relationship with God and with each other, so that we can be forgiven and restored and renewed to new life. Jesus calls us to do three things in the gospel reading from Matthew. And they are the three marks of Lent: repentance, prayer, and giving, charity. So repentance means that, in the truest sense of the word, that you stop what you're doing, you're sorry for what you're doing, you're realizing how much it makes you a broken person. And you turn away from that because you know that you can't do it on your own, and you ask God to help you turn around and to change your life for the better. That's repentance, and that's what we're called to do, especially in these 6 weeks of Lent, but certainly all the time. The second thing that we're called to do that will help us with repentance is to pray. I don't know how much time you spend in prayer every day, but between you said,